Vande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Vande Nityananda Sauditam Sri Nanda Nandanam Vande Radhika Charanodayam Gopijano Samayuktam Bindavanam Manoharam Vanchakalpataru Vashyakipasindu Vavachu Patitanam Pavune Bhavishnavibhyo Namo Namah Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langhetigiram Yatki Patam Hangabandi Paramanandamadu Brindavi Tulside Bhaipiyavi Kesavasaja Shna Bhakti Pade Devi Satta Bhattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Narunca Iva Narottama Deving Swarasvating Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodakshya Jagod Bharanya Deyam Sada Paribhavagna Vavishchaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virunchenutam Saranyam Bhittatiham Panutopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanarvindam Yat Pada Pallavanukha Chandamani Chattai Vishwarjita Kimapigavavadu Swadarshi Purna Nuragara Sasagara Saramurti Sharadhikamai Kadakipam Karosh Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Ajanulambita bhujau kanaka badatu Sankirtanai kapitaru kamala yataksho Vishambaru dijavaru jugadharma palo Bande jagat priyakaro karuna bhataro Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chadada Sinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamanango madapuharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagi sajasya badane Lakshmir yasacha bakshashi Yasyasti hide sambhid Tvam nishinga maham bhaji Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Marto yada tekto samastha karma, nibiditatma vichikirsito me, tadam ritattvam pratipaddamano, mayatma bhuyayo cha kalpate bhai. Marto yada tekto samastha karma, nibiditatma vichikirsito me, tadam ritattvam pratipaddamano, mayatma bhuyayo kalpate bhai. Gauriya Goshtipati, Srisila Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, to seek for popularity and pure devotion, totally different thing. To seek for popularity is not actually bhakti, it is not Vaishnava Dharma. Actually, to seek the satisfaction of Sri Krishna, entire satisfaction of Sri Krishna, is called bhakti Vaishnava Dharma. And to seek the satisfaction or personal, satisfaction, is called non-devotion. And this thing, you will have to shout, you will have to preach, you will have to shout boldly, you will have to shout this thing, boldly you will have to preach this thing in front of public. It is called Jivedaya. When you are going to announce this point in front of public openly, fearlessly, it is called actually Jivodaya. To protect all bonded soul from Maya is called Jivedaya. You know, Bhakti Mimu Thakur already right. Jivedaya Krishna Nam Sarva Dharmasa. Krishna Samsar Karo Chari Anachar. Jivedaya Krishna Nam Sarva Dharmasa. So, Jivedaya, this point we should understand. If we can understand what is Jivedaya, Prabhupada speaking, to give back the consciousness of Jiva, to understand, so that actually Jivatma can understand, this is my position. Jive Sharupa Krishna Nitya Das. If Jivatma can feel this point by the help of a Guru Vaishnava, it is called actual Jivedaya. Naturally, those bonded souls, they have their karma, different kind of desire they have. So, they cannot follow pure devotion. Anyway, environment also not going to support them because situation is already contaminated. But one thing sure, those who are 100% sincere, 100% sincere, having no duplicity, then I already told many times that divine help we can get. So, Jivedaya, to announce this point, that to seek popularity, personal popularity is not bhakti, it is not Vaishnava Dharma. To seek the satisfaction, 20th satisfaction of Krishna is called bhakti or Vaishnava Dharma. And to announce this boldly, it is called Jivedaya. In the name of Jivedaya, so many organizations, so many, society, they are running, they are showing that we are doing something for Jiva. Paropokar, benefit for. But if I am going to get some benefit from you, or somebody, which is ultimately going to put me more and more into Maya, it is not actually Jivedaya. If I am going to get some help from you, okay, you are going to help me. But if that kind of help going to put me into Maya, more and more Maya, then it is not actually Jivadaya. That's why Sarup Gosai was bound to write Amando Daya Daya. You can remember. Amando Daya Daya means that if I am going to get some kripa from pure Guru Vaishnava, there is no possibility that out of that I can develop some amangal. Not possible. Provided I am perfect, I am okay. Okay means saranagati, am I perfect? If it is true. In that case, no question. Because all other qualities, I already told, the only one quality is a pivoted point. And Vaishnavas, they have 26 different kind of qualities. Out of this, one quality is the center point of all qualities. That is called Krishnaika Saran. That is called Krishnaika Saran. If Krishnaika Saran, surrendered unto lotus feet of Krishna, if this point is absent, not there, then all other qualities, what you can find in me, that is material qualities. That is called material qualities. Because Krishnaika Saran, this quality is not there. In that case, all other qualities useless. Material qualities. But be sure, a Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, can have countless qualities, mainly 26 qualities. And the main qualities is Krishnaika Saran. And we cannot expect any quality of a Vaishnava. We cannot expect any quality of a Vaishnava inside any material person. There is a big confusion. You know, apparently it seems that this pure Guru Vaishnava, he has this kind of quality also, that man in this material world, he is also having that kind of quality. It is impossible. Because the qualities of Guru Vaishnava is aprakita. It seems, you know, apparently it seems almost same, but it cannot so happen, you know, because all the qualities of a pure Vaishnava is always transcendental qualities, and material people, those who have no devotion, nothing, maybe they have ethical character, all different kind of, you know, qualities, which is appreciable in this material world, but this can never be compared with the qualities of a Vaishnava. We cannot compare. So, Jivedaya, actually, Sarup Gosai speaking, you know, Amandodaya, Bhuyad Amandodaya, Bhuyad Amandodaya. Amandodaya mana, I am going to get kipa from Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Varga. Out of that kipa, I cannot expect, you know, some problem. Maya cannot come. Because they are going to show me kipa, which is pure kipa, not, you know, contaminated kipa like material, you know, people they are doing. So, Prabhupada speaking, to announce this point, that, you know, if I like to announce this point, that to seek the satisfaction of Krishna is bhakti, and to seek my personal pratishtha, everything is not at all bhakti. And if I can loudly preach this point, then maybe the whole world can come to attack me. Prabhupada speaking, this absolute truth, this is actually absolute truth. If I fear that though they can attack me, so I should not speak this. Prabhupada speaking, in the fear that the whole world can attack me, I am not going to stop speaking about the absolute truth, absolute way. I never want to stop speaking about the absolute teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, absolute way. I know that I am not going to get popularity, it is true, but I can give full satisfaction to Krishna. Because personal enjoyment, personal popularity, everything, it is my enjoyment, enjoying mood. It has no connection with Krishna bhajan. And Krishna bhog, what is the total satisfaction of Krishna? Prabhupada speaking, especially in this Kali Yuga, if I like to seek the total satisfaction of Krishna, then I will have to sing about the absolute truth, absolute way. Param Vijayati Sri Krishna Sankirtanam. This is the slogan of Gauriya Math. Gauriya devotee it should be. So, what is the enjoyment? How Krishna can enjoy? How I can give enjoyment to Krishna, full satisfaction? Because Sankirtan Pita in Kali Kal can get total satisfaction by my absolute Kirtan. By my absolute Kirtan, if I can have the chance by the mercy of Guru Vishnam to sing the, you know, to sing the glories of that, Supreme Lord, about that absolute truth, absolute way, Vastav Sattva Kirtan, then I can give total satisfaction. Sankirtanaika Pitaru. Pitaru Sankirtanaika Pitaru mean, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda, non-different. That's why Sankirtanaika Pitaru, you know, Vishambarau, Dijabarau, all, you know, Divachan. We are using, you know, that's why it is, you know, Sankirtan Pita Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to satisfy him, I will have to sing about that absolute truth, absolute way, by the order of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, everything. Prabhupada also speaking thing. This thing, Prabhupada speaking, I cannot arrange, you know, I cannot give satisfaction to any people. I cannot seek the satisfaction of any material people. I cannot. It is not my duty. But at present, situation is very complicated. Whereas I already told, any kind of compromise is not possible in the way of pure devotion. When we can discuss Rai Ramananda Sangvad in details, then we can understand that why Mahaprabhu repeatedly speaking to Rai Ramananda, not that, you can go, okay, you can go more ahead to speak about the absolute truth. Mahaprabhu is not satisfied. Because preliminary thing, Rai Ramananda starting for preliminary thing, by the inspiration of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rai Ramananda started speaking from basic thing and gradually going up and up and up and up to give the secret treasure of Raganuga Bhajan, topmost. Not only Raganuga Bhajan, we can get, you know, very top secret Radha Prem, everything, which is the topmost excellency in the way of Krishna Bhajan. That what Mahaprabhu wanted to show us in his full lifetime, Hilila, you know. So Prabhupada speaking, I can never try to satisfy any material people. This is not my duty. And unique Acharya Ji Prabhupada is this unique, that Prabhupada never took any physical, any direct seva from anybody. Direct seva meaning messaging of leg, everything. Never in whole life, never Prabhupada took anything. And anybody going to give some big donation, speak still, Prabhupada never wanted to apply some oil onto his lotus feet. Never. One rich man, he was expressing his, you know, respect for Prabhupada. For Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was bound to give a Fiat Gari that time. Fiat Gari. But still, Prabhupada never told that you give some special seva to that man because he has given this seva. A pure sadhu is he who never think anything related to his personal interest. He is thinking that Krishna Seva is the main factor. He is giving for Krishna Seva. He is giving for Krishna, not for personal. If I have some personal desire or any weak point of enjoyment, then I can go to apply oil under lotus feet of that man. Otherwise, no question. One incident I can speak so you can understand what a pure sadhu is like. I can give one example in Vrindavan. You know, our example of Prabhupada, what I am giving, all example of Prabhupada is ideal. But still, one example I like to give, you know, that in Vrindavan, in Nimbarka Sampradaya, one Siddha Mahatma was there. He is doing all the time Bhagavad Naam, Sankirtan and everything. One day from Delhi, one very important personality coming with one devotee to take darshan of the lotus feet of that Maharaj. Maybe ministerial level, I forget actually. He is coming and actually that devotee coming in front of Maharaj in Vrindavan, in temple, and speaking Maharaj, giving identity of that man. He is very high qualified man, Maharaj coming, he is this post, he is from, you know, he is coming from Delhi, this, that. Maharaj not speaking anything. At least 3-4 times when repeatedly speaking that thing, then Maharaj become very angry. Maharaj speaking, what I can do? What you want? What you want I do? I can do aruti of that man? What do you think? You speak, repeatedly you are speaking, okay. This is, you know, this is the temple of Supreme Lord. Anybody can come. There actually some, actually everybody can get entry. Those who are going to, you know, pay respect to Supreme Lord. So repeatedly you are speaking, what you want? I can do aruti of that man? Because he is important personality? Is that? A sadhu is never influenced by any material prestige or honor, anything, nothing. It's not possible. But the idea of Prabhupada, actually when I can discuss about Prabhupada and Srila Prabhupada and Radha Anugatya, when I can start this discussion, because one point is vast discussion we need. I cannot give that much time, so very shortly you can start this discussion about Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, and Radha Anugatya. What is the excellency? Radha Anugatya. You know, Radha Anugatya. So I can show this. So in Radha Anugatya, there is so many technique, so many, you know, secret, you know, technique, you know, very fine technique there. So common people, they cannot understand. It was the usual procedure for the preaching of Chaitanya Bani, I already told, maybe tomorrow I can discuss. For the actual preaching of Chaitanya Bani, Prabhupada told, I can come down to any level. For the actual preaching of Chaitanya Bani. Because through Chaitanya Bani, only through Chaitanya Bani, we can protect the whole world. I mean all Jivatma. Of course, if they are going to pay attention to my speech, then I can put guarantee. When Prabhupada speaking, that people expressing some doubt, Brahmando Tarite Shakti Dware Jane Jane, you know, they are singing, Mane, what is there, Mara there? You know, Hoi Yachen, Hoi Ben, Paburjato Das, is this kind of kirtan there, you know, morning time? Then, that time, somebody is going to express some doubt about Maharaj Brahmando Tarite Shakti Dware Jane Jane, Ebedo Purane Guno Gai Jeva Shune. So, those devotees, they are singing these glories that a pure devotee, Vaishnava, can deliver the whole universe. Brahmando Tarite Shakti Dware Jane, they have every all each and every parshad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They have that kind of power. They can emancipate, they can deliver, countless jivas. But it cannot so happen. Why? Because they are not going to pay attention to the speech the instruction of those Guru Vaishnava. They are not paying attention. At least they are going to pay some attention. Then it is that I already told that it was possible for Rasikananda Prabhu. How it was possible for Rasikananda Prabhu to draw the attention of elephant, Gopal Das? That elephant was one so-called, you know, Vaishnava, he done aparad in Bakura district. After doing aparad, he was bound to take in the form of, you know, like in Gajendra Mokshan, you know, Indradumna Raja took the form of elephant, Gajendra, and Huhu, one Gandharva, he was making one mistake here unto a lotus feet of Deval Rishi, Agastya Muni, Indradumna Raja done aparad unto lotus feet of Agastya Rishi, and this, you know, Huhu Gandharva, and unto a lotus feet of Deval Rishi, aparad was done by him. That's why immediately by their curse, those Rishi actually, they curse them. You know, one Rishi, I mean Deval Rishi, and curse to who? Gandharva, and that Rishi giving a curse to him. That's why he was bound to take in the form of elephant and he was in the form of crocodile. The discussion is that Prabhupada and Acharya Shiv. So about aparad in details, I have no scope to discuss, but I can touch this point because yesterday some question came from Slovenia. So I can touch this point. If aparad, jodi aparad uthe hati matha, upore ba shuki jaye, upore ja shuki jaye patha. Upari va chindi, that's why chaitanya charitamrita. It is then the bhakti root get irradiated and dry up. Bhakti cannot get. So aparad, it's a big thing, it's a big area we have to discuss. But if I can touch one point, Vaishnava aparad, if you have done Vaishnava aparad, then you will have to think when you have done Vaishnava aparad, how you have done Vaishnava aparad. If you can detect, if you go on thinking, then if you can detect, then you will have to beg for pardon. Like I can give you an example, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in very, very plain, ordinary form. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to lead life. Even common people, they don't know that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is a great Vaishnava, Gaur Parshad. Nobody knows. Even Sarupdas Baba, one, he was expressing some negligence, yeah, useless. No tilak, no mala, nothing actually, doing kirtan, speaking. That time Sarupdas, Babaji Maharaj, he was, you know, making some aparad. After that he went on thinking, what I have done? Why I cannot do Harinam properly? Why I am feeling some problem at heart? And smoothness all gone. What can be the reason? Then we think, maybe I have done aparad unto lotus feet of that, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Then he begged for pardon. He say, I cannot see any tilak mala, anything, nothing. So I was in a position to ignore you, you know, and avoid you. That was great aparad. Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing. But actually, how you can see tilak mala still today? I have not accepted Guru Charan is not there still today. I will have to, you know, take shelter of Guru Charan this way. So, but still, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is Nitya Parshad. Bhaktivinoda Thakur externally going to take shelter of somebody, some Guru, it's okay. But still, long before, you can remember I told, if some small boy, if you find from birth he is going to show, you know, so nice Shraddha, very nice. But nobody understands. Because we know without taking shelter unto the lotus feet of pure devotees, Guru Vaishnava, not only that, but also without taking shelter unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava, by submitting everything, top to bottom, मानस देहो गेह जो किचु मोरो माने टॉप टू बॉटम यस्टरडे आई वाज गिविंग दिस आर्गुमेंट विदाउट सबमिटिंग एवरीथिंग टॉप टू बॉटम एंड टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ सद्गुरु वैष्णव वन कैन नॉट गेट परफेक्ट एसोसिएशन परफेक्ट इनिशिएशन एसोसिएशन ऑल्सो एन इनिशिएशन एंड दैट इन दैट केस द इनिशिएशन इज नॉट कंप्लीट इनिशिएशन only after submission from heart with all my belongings everything body speech and mind everything when I can submit at the lotus feet of a pure guru vaishnav mane gurudev sadguru then and only then the question of getting then and only then the question of getting dibya gyan dib dhatu actually mane bright very clear you know It's called dibya gyan, meaning transcendental knowledge. So transcendental knowledge can never get manifested. You cannot find transcendental knowledge inside your heart until and unless you are going to submit 100%. Not that property, everything, all my property. Okay, but I can give something to Gurudev. Okay, no problem. This kind of mood, actually, I am not speaking. You will have to give everything. But you must be prepared to give everything if the situation demands so. You know, if there's sometime Rishi Muni Guru Vaishnav testing. You know, Harishchandra Maharaj, heavy testing was there in his life. Harishchandra Maharaj, you know, so he was just like a beggar, more than beggar, but still, he was holding. That the pillar of that absolute truth, he never wanted to miss, you know, truthfulness. So ultimately, he was given back everything. So this way, Guru Vaishnav sometime going to test you. You can submit everything or not. So many, you know, example I can give from Shastra. So we must be ready. If I am not going to give everything unto Lotus Feet of Guru Padma, I can never speak Harikatha. Because I am speaking by the mercy, by the power of Guru Padma. Guru Padma allowing Tattak and everything in my heart, that I am speaking. I have no capacity. I should think it, that everything done by Prabhupada Guru Bharga, nothing I cannot do. So if I am going to reserve some mind secretly, if I am going to reserve some money secretly, maybe 10 lakhs rupees, secretly, then be sure I am a cheater. I am going to prove that I am Niskinchan. But I am a cheater. I am keeping secretly. Maybe 50 lakhs rupees I keep somewhere. I am going to show that I am Niskinchan. In that case, it is a cheating case. I can never speak Harikatha. So you see, Rai Ramananda ultimately, you know, ultimately, in front of Mahaprabhu, all everything, leave everything, Mahaprabhu. He lived, Rai Ramananda living everything and came unto the lotus feet of Gauranga because even my body, soul and mind, I have no controlling over that. I should not have any demand that this is my body. I cannot speak. This is called Diksha. Diksha, actually foolish people don't understand. They think it is my body. Whereas Mahaprabhu wanted to prove in front of Sanatan, Sanatan, you have taken decision to give your life, you know. What do you mean? Huh? Your body is now my body, and you are going to show submission, na? You told me Saranagata, but you are going to, you know, finish, you are going to give your life. What is this decision? What is Siddhanta? Your body is not yours, my body. When a disciple can think 100%, when a disciple can think 100% that way, in that case, the power of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Guru Bhargava bound to come. Not that Maharaj, kipa karo kapat. Maharaj, kipa karo foolish. Guru Padma used to speak, my son, they are speaking this way. Kipa karo, kipa karo. Are, Kripa already you are going to give, foolish. Kripa already you can give, you can get. You need not do some, you know, you need not play some drama. You can get Kripa automatically. Guru Padma used to say, they are speaking that way. But Kripa is an automatic factor. If you are in line, if your submission is perfect, you are ready to submit everything unto lotus feet of Guru Gauranga. Like I can give the example of Goswami Maharaj, the great. I can give the example of Goswami Maharaj, who is the great, you know. He, after, you know, without you speaking to Baba, because that time when he was the officer of railway officer, that time he used to send 50 rupees. 50 rupees mean at present big amount. I cannot compare how much Roman, how much amount up to date I cannot know. Conversion I cannot speak. But 50 rupees that time, because I am speaking long ago, where that time actually one paisa, so much, you know, valuable. In my life I have also seen 1 paisa, 2 paisa, you know. Father used to give me 2 paisa only for lajan, lemon juice in noon time. Give me 100 times. Okay, take 2 paisa only. 1 paisa, 2 paisa. Now, if I give 100 rupees no to a very small boy, he is not satisfied. Oh, 100, what I can do? Only to buy water, it takes 40 rupees, 50 rupees. Then, water. We never thought in our life that we will have to buy water. Never. Because contamination was not there. At present, so much costly, everything. So, Goswami Maharaj, the when took decision to leave service, everything, then some of the disciples of Prabhupada, well, they were bound to speak, Bhakti Saranga Prabhu going to leave service, but we are getting 50 rupees in month per month actually. Okay, maybe it is the desire of Nityananda. Goswami Maharaj, without speaking to Prabhupada, in a lorry, taking all his beads and everything, with wife coming unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada and speaking, Prabhupada, now I am totally going to show 100% submission unto your lotus feet. What to do and not to do, I don't know. All my belongings means nothing, actually some baits and everything, you carry everything. Now, if you can throw me outside, Mott, you can throw, if you can give me, Prabhupada laughing, Prabhupada thinking, what kind of, you know, submission? You know, he's not going to fear that how to maintain this, that. They are actually, Chaitanya Mahat that time was not so, opulences was not there. But gradually, whole Mayapur lands and properties, everything came in the book list of, in the register of Chaitanya Mahat later on. By that time, it was very, you know, typical situation. Those devotees, even I heard from Guru Padma, even that time, they couldn't arrange one plate. They couldn't arrange one plate sometime. There's not sufficient rice. One day, you know, some devotees, Prabhupada coming from library and gradually going somewhere and watching, you are taking prasadam this way in the, you know, because they are taking prasadam in ground. It is dham actually. Those who are doing koti namjagya, those who are doing namjagya every day, there are some rules and regulation. You will have to continue your nam, you will have to put prasadam on ground to take like a dog, go grass, go mata. You will have to continue 3 times so you can take water. Every time you will have to open your clothes if you are going to pass urine. All achaman, again nam, all day and night. You know, this kind of strong rules and regulation. But Prabhupada when coming down, say, you are taking prasadam this way in the ground and so small, little prasadam, a little prasadam. Then devotees, they are speaking, Prabhupada, we have enjoying mood, Prabhupada. So we are practicing. Actually, they are not speaking, there is no rice in Bandara. In Bandar, there is no rice, not speaking. Prabhupada, never mind. We are actually material personage. We have enjoying mood. So we are practicing Prabhupada. Please never. Prabhupada antarjami, knowing everything. Prabhupada, tears rolling down his cheeks, looking at them with very compassionate mood. Oh my God. Oh Gaur. Oh Gaur. There little prasadam. There was a little prasadam residue. They mix with dal some and there divide into like madhukuri in hand. This was the you know system that time. So Gosai Maharaj that time Gosai Maharaj coming, what a kind of, you know, dedication you should think, you know, all the time, you know. You know, one devotee coming from outside, but sufficient prasadam was not there. Somehow, in my life also many times it happens so. When I come into temple, there was no prasadam. Whereas they know I gone to Nishingapalli by the order of Guru Padma, I can come back by time. In Nishingapalli, they request me, Prabhu, you must take prasadam because almost 2 o'clock. I say, no, no. I am going to carry the prasadam of Guru Padma. So what? We are giving the first share to Guru Padma. You can take prasadam with all devotees here. I cannot take. You give me prasadam in the same packet, I mean same patra, pot. I can go fast and offer to Guru Padma, then I can take. So I come back, fasting whole day. Now after that 3 or 4 o'clock I reach, there was no prasadam. For that we cannot start shouting. Why there is no prasadam? We need prasadam. You know, we cannot shout. It is the, you know, we cannot shout that way because prasadam in kipa. Many times it happens so. Many times it happens so. We couldn't get prasadam. So what? I used to go to Kalna for a bhikkha here, there. When I come back, there was no prasadam residue left. Maybe somebody has taken prasadam. It was there maybe. Coming from Vrindavan without fasting whole row, you know, whole journey. No prasadam. Still, we should not express our, you know, this kind of mood. It's not good. One day, one devotee coming from some place, you know, when he come back, there was no prasadam. And that time, actually, our Narahari Prabhu is the mother of Chaitanya Math, giving total responsibility by Prabhupada. But if that man when come back, that devotee is not going to get any prasadam. That surely means that Narahari Prabhu is also fasting. If somebody not going to get prasadam, be sure that Narahari Prabhu is also fasting. Because if there is a little prasadam residue, Narahari Prabhu going to arrange that prasadam for him. He himself not going to take. That was called, you know, excellent love, excellent Guru Seva, mana, excellent Guru Seva. We cannot imagine at present. We cannot see that kind of idealism at present. So we are running here and there like madman. That man shouting, that devotee, so-called devotee. Then Prabhupada coming out from library, Prabhupada hearing, there is no prasadam for me, why? They are shouting. Then Prabhupada coming out from library, gradually, and coming to him. Prabhupada speaking, you cannot see prasadam. You cannot see prasadam. So much prasadam here and there. You cannot see prasadam. Come on. Come on with me. You and me both, we can take prasadam. Prabhupada going to the dustbin. Prabhupada going to take. You know, here, you can also take. I can. That was the teaching of a unique acharya like Prabhupada. Unique acharya like Prabhupada can speak like that. Nobody can speak like that. We think prasad means only, you know, some food stuff we can take. You know, we are, you know, burning, our belly burning, so we can take. Not that. Prasadam means kipa. That teaching, nobody giving today. At present, we are staying in a hostel. Going to protect everybody and I am going to protect your self-interest, you are going to protect my self-interest. This way we are mutual interest, we are going to protect, we are going to do Goshti Bhajan. This is not actually Goshti Bhajan. The success of Goshti Bhajan was shown by Prabhupada. The success of Goshti Bhajan was shown by Prabhupada. How? Mara Goshti Bhajan means there should be very pure devotee in the group. Otherwise, bonded soul cannot see idealism. They cannot follow him. So, if there is no idealism, if there is no pure devotees in the society, in the temple, then all patients are there. That's when we are going to open new temple. Mean we are going to open new hospital without any doctor. We are not going to appoint any doctor. There is no doctor who can give treatment to bonded soul. Bonded soul, even after getting heavy treatment, full treatment, but still they are not going to, cure their material disease. In one small article, Prabhupada used to write, in a very, very, fantastic way, Prabhupada, wrote one, article in which was published long ago in Gauriya Hospital. And in Gauriya Hospital, Prabhupada speaking, there are so many patients coming, bonded souls. They are taking shelter in hospital. And those pure Guru Vaishnav, they are going to give treatment to them properly with medicine is Harikatha, Sankirtan, Harikatha, Mahaprasadam, everything. Harinam, Harikatha, Sankirtan, everything is a life-saving medicine. Life-saving medicine, you see, and Prabhupada giving description, there's a patient there in number one bed, that the patient is having too much material affinity for money, everything, and proper treatment going on. Second bed is having tremendous erection for woman position, and the number third bed is having, he's very cruel, his mood is very dangerous mood, he's always, each and every time he become angry. This kind of one by one, Prabhupada is going to speak about all different kind of diseases they are having, respective disease, accordingly treatment going on. So you understand, if you are not foolish, you should understand what I mean to say. Then an acharya, what a great acharya Srila Prabhupada is. So Prabhupada wanted to speak, and acharya should have that kind of power. A pure sadguru, a pure acharya is so powerful. Even if you are staying thousands of miles away from Guru Padma, still Guru Padma can realize what is there inside your heart. Guru Padma can realize. You see the mood of Guru Padma, Sadguru, Acharya. He can realize everything. What is going to happen? What is your mood? What is my mood? Everything they can. Accordingly, he is taking step to rectify my disease. That is the system. If we are going to follow a bonded soul who is not having any, even you, who is not having control over your sense organ and body and mind, what use? Prabhupada speaking, if I personally going to commit suicide, if I personally going to commit suicide, it's still okay. It is not okay. We cannot approve suicide, because suicide is very offensive. But still, if a person is going to die, it's still okay. But if one false acharya is going to die with all of his thousands of followers, then if you are intelligent, you try to think, Prabhupada speaking, what will happen? Those who are kapat acharya, those who are bonded soul, acting a play, they are playing a drama of acharya, taking respect, everything. Maharaj, they are giving their lotus feet in front of them, and Mataji, you worship, you wash my, Like I told you, no, that day, in front of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, so-called idiot Pratishtha Kami, who is, you know, always busy with Pratishtha, that kind of so-called idiot devotee, he is not actually a so-called devotee. He is speaking in front of Gaurakishore Baba by putting his leg into a pot of water, leg into the pot, and speaking, I am a topmost Brahman, I am Vaishnav. My foot was, you know, water was of my lotus feet can go in vain. Gaurakishore Babaji, why? No, I cannot allow it to go in vain. Give me. I can drink. Then Gaurakishore Babaji taking that water and drinking. Oh my God. Oof. Even in dream we cannot think. Oh my God, so pasanda, so heartless there, you know. That is why we see, we are speaking that Paramahansa Acharya Varja. Usually, those who are Paramahansa actually, you know, they are not acting as Acharya, but the Acharan, Acharyan means their Acharan is itself Acharya. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. You know. So, this way you see, so Kapat, if they are going to show Kapat, you know, Saranagati, Kapat, you know, Bhagavad Bhakta, Harinam Bhakta, Chaitanya Charitamrita, they are seeking all, they are and memorize everything. In front of public, they can play a drama, so idiot people, foolish people, they have no sincerity, they are not actually interested to get actual Kripa. So naturally, why I told that Parikshit Maharaj, somebody putting question, why Parikshit Maharaj allow Koli to say, why Parikshit Maharaj allow Koli to stay in his kingdom? Why? Parikshit Maharaj could easily kill Koli. Parikshit Maharaj is Mahabhagavat. Also, you know, I can speak the sloka after some time, I can show. In one sense, Parikshit Maharaj also acting as an Acharya. In a hearing patience, you know. And Vishnu Savane Parikshit Abhavat Vyasaki Kirtane. Vishnu Savane Parikshit Sri Vishnu Sravane Parikshit Abhavat Vyasaki Kirtane Prahladaha Smarane Tadangri Bhajane Lakshihi Prithupujane Akrurastu Abhivandane Kapipatir Dasya Atho Sakshya Arjuna Sarvashvatma Nivedane Bali Rabhut Krishnapti Resham Param. It is from Paddavoli, written by Rupa Goswami Pad. Sri Vishnu Sravade. So each one of them, I am speaking about Parikshit Maharaj, I am speaking about Sukhdev Goswami, I am speaking about Prahlad Maharaj, I am speaking about Lakshi Devi, I am speaking about Prithu Maharaj, I am speaking about Akrur Maharaj, I am speaking about Hanumanji Maharaj, I am speaking about Arjunji Maharaj, I am speaking about Boliji Maharaj. Now you speak, they are Acharya or not? Because each one of them, they are going to show the excellency of one, ninefold of bhakti. Each one of them going to show us the, you know, the idealism of one bhajan procedure. Like how to hear Harikatha? We'll have to hear Harikatha like Parikshit Maharaj. How to speak Harikatha? How? Well, absorbing way. When we are going to speak Harikatha, if we are going to think about some monetary profit and loss, then I am idiot number one. I am a beast. I cannot speak. If I am not going to speak absorbing way, if I cannot get lost in this, you know, world of, you know, Guru Bharga, be sure I cannot speak Harikatha. Harikatha is not such a thing. I am not a platform speaker that I can memorize something and give in front of you to get clapping and money. I am less interested about any kind of advantage you like to give me. Less interested. Only I like to continue my seva with all my children, those who are going to help me. Okay. I can give them scope to do seva. But I never like to give any scope for body seva, this, that. No, never. I hate. You know, under the guidance of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda, I never learned this kind of thing, bad thing, you know. So, So, Parikshit Maharaj in one sense acting as Acharya, because he is showing the Acharya of, you know, Shravan how to hear. He is going to show that kind of idealism. So why not I can say he is also one kind of Acharya in front of me? So Vishnu Shravane Parikshit Abhavat, Vyasaki, Vyasdev, the son of Vyasdev, externally, I don't like to speak son, this word. I don't like, but Sukhdev Goswami never, you know, think he is the father, and Vyasdev Goswami never going to think he is the father. Prabhupada never want to, never think that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never think he is my son. It's material conception. Yeah. My son mean have some enjoying mood. He is my son. Like Hiranyakashipu. Hey, Prahlad is my son. He must obey, carry out my order. It's called one enjoying mood. My son mean he must carry out my order. It's enjoying mood. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur never expressed that kind of mood. This very dangerous mood. You know, it's a question of bondage, you know. So, Sukhdev Goswami, when speaking Harikatha, then how it is possible the father, forefather, or every grandfather, they all everything coming. Vasishtha, Bharadraj, Parasar, you know, everybody coming to hear Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Parikshit. If they have at all, hey, it's a boy of 16 years, who, I know more than him. It is the idea of Shishupal. It is the idea of Kamsa. It is the idea of Ravan. It's not the idea of a devotee. I know more than that. I am experienced sadhu. I am long, you know. Long time I am doing. Who is he? 16 years. Hare Maharaj, this mood is just against pure devotion. At present is applicable in the Maharaj, they are speaking, seniority should be given priority. At present this is the formula. Maharaj, in one sava, if there is some idiot man, very aged, 90 years old, idiot. Everybody going to make him sabhapati, chairman. They say, they are like grihastha devotees. Grihastha people, you know. He is senior, he should be given. What do you mean by seniority? Seniority must be given priority. Seniority should be given priority. This is material formula. We cannot follow this formula. That's why, if Sukhdev Goswami is only 16 years away, old, still, all, you know, Rishi Mani, they are going to participate in the Harikatha. Because they never think it is my son, this, that, you know, material idea. It's material conception. You know. So, seniority should be given priority, the material idea. So, Parikshit Maharaj hearing, Acharya of hearing, you know, Shravan Guru, how to, you know, Shravan Guru mean that you can take it in different way. I like to speak my main, I meant to say, the idealism of Shravan, we can learn from Parikshit Maharaj. How to hear Harikatha with full attention. Maharaj, a speaker can get lost in the world of, you know, Guru Varga. When those who are going to participate in Harikatha, they are also excellent. It is written in the quality of, you know, how to hear, how to sing glories, what is the qualities about Bhagavad Prabhachan, qualities. It is written, Harikatha can become full of rasa. Harikatha can become full of rasa when those who are going to hear Harikatha, they are all sincere, absorbing where they are hearing, and he, the Mahabhagavad, who is going to speak Harikatha, absorbing way, that's called excellent. This is almost rare. At present is almost rare. You know, those who are going to hear Harikatha, they are also absorbing mood. They are absorbing mood, they are hearing Harikatha. Also, he who is he, speaking Harikatha, Mahabhagavad Vaishnava, is also absorbing mood. No information about this material world. He is going to get lost in Harikatha and Tattha, in the world of that Guru Varga, Vaikuntha Jagat. Standing on material platform, it is quite impossible. standing on material platform, it is quite impossible to speak about that, you know, absolute truth, which is coming from Vaikuntha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking in Bengali, you know, Vaikuntha Parshad, Bhagavane Nijajan Chara, Kehoi Vaikuntha Bartha Bolite Parena in Bengali. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, nobody can speak about that absolute truth, absolute way, until unless he is standing on Vaikuntha platform. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, nobody is speaking. Everyone like to hide this point. You know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Nobody can speak about the absolute truth, the absolute way, until and unless he is going to stand on absolute platform, I mean Vaikuntha platform. Vaikuntha jagater kotha kehoi bolite parena. Baddhajib, oh Maharaj, he is, you know, very erudite scholar. So what? Erudite scholar doesn't mean he is great devotee. You know? Sometimes we are so foolish, we have no conception. So poor we are, no? Our knowledge is so poor. We cannot even think. You know? Sometimes we can see in this material world we can find Pratibha. Mahaprabhu also wanted to speak this thing in his Gaur Leela and Navadvip Leela. Mahaprabhu was bound to speak this way, but we cannot understand. We have enough mind, we can go to market and buy books, you can read. But how you can understand this Siddhanta Vichar? Eh? I can see in my life. When Guru Maharaj never wanted to give Diksha to anybody. No, I cannot. But forcefully, the Maharaj, you must give. After that, Maharaj, and then after that, Maharaj speak, I am not going to think about anything. I am depending upon, you know, if you give order, if you all think fit, then you can. I mean, Guru Maharaj wanted to give responsibility to them. Because all the time, Maharaj is in absorbing mood in bhajan. What to think? No, not, yes, no. Well, do. Only you can say that if you think fit, you can speak. Now, after that, we become sahajya, we put anya outside people, Maharaj, you can give diksha to Harinam. Okay, you are speaking. Never Guru Maharaj wanted to make give diksha. Oh, I know his mood. Oof. So pure devotee. Oh. Then after that, I have seen in my life one German devotee, a young chap, maybe 22 years, 23, very young, coming in monk. He is paying some donation, and after that, not to Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj was less interested about donation. And he was given one room. He started staying in temple without any seva. Enough money was there. Within very short time, I find his room is full of books. Even I put all books on your body, you can die. So, heaps of books. He buy and decorate home. After that day and night, he go on reading. Go on reading. Then after that, what is there? What was the result? He was feeling some karma. And after, he gone, leaving everything. There is a system. Actually, without seva, if I can realize everything, Then everybody can go and buy books and market and they realize. Not that actually. So you see, so each and every, you know, fold, you know, Sukhdev Goswami never think that Vyasadeva is my father. Vyasadeva never think is my son. No, that they are going to attend Harikatha. They want satsanga. I can discuss all in detail about satsanga. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, satsanga is our life and breath, respiration. If we are going to leave satsanga, all gone. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, satsanga, dusanga, tag, to avoid evil association is like our respiration. You know, don't try to take it easy way. Try to understand. You know, so Then this sloka prapadavali, Sri Vishnu, Sravane Parikshit Abhavat, Vyasa Kirtane. How to sing the glories of Supreme Lord? We can learn from Parikshit Maharaj. Parikshit Maharaj Paramahansa Sastra. I don't know when, which life I can become Paramahansa, bonded soul. So this way Parikshit and Vyasa Kirtane and the Acharya of, you know, Sankirtan is Sukadeva Goswami. Prahlad Maharaj in Swaran, in constant remembering, Swaran. And Charan Seva, Lakshmi Devi, Prithu in Archan, Akrur Abhivandan, glorifying the lotus feet of Prabhu Abhivandan, you know. And Hanumanji Maharaj, Dasya, Kapipati, Dasya. This kind of, you know, servitorship, you know, is not possible, like Hanumanji Maharaj. Sometime we find, you know, and enjoy this one kind of leela. Bharatji Maharaj also expressing about the servitorship of Hanumanji Maharaj. You know, this one kind of leela, actually. Bharatji Maharaj is no ordinary man. You know, he is the Supreme Lord himself. Because who is Ram, he is Bharat. Who is Lakshan? Satyugna, all in four different words. Like Panchatatana, Gaurhari, who is Gaurhari? He is Nityananda. He is Nityananda, he is Gaurhari. And a Panchatatana in four, five different ways I can discuss, because Prabhupada wanted to give us a unique treasure of Guru Sarup. I am very interested to discuss someday. Maybe I can try. So, Lakshmi Devi, you know, Akrura Vyanda Kapipati Dasya Shaksha. We are not going to enter into Golokdham. We are speaking about this kind of, you know, standard of friendship, you know, is unique. We are not going to enter into that. That is different. Golok is different. If we compare with Golok, then in that case, Arjun not going to get any rank, not place, no place. So sarvasvatma nivedane bali rabhu. Bali Maharaj is the swaying idealism of how to give everything unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan Guru Vaishnava. You know, Bali Maharaj, there was nothing left in the life of Bali Maharaj to pay, because all gone. Now only the body was there. Bindhavali, the wife of, you know, wife of Bali Maharaj, speaking, why not you speak to Prabhu? Prabhu, your third leg you can put on my head. This is the only space, you know. Then Bali Maharaj, you know, Bamanji Maharaj was very happy. Very happy. You know. So this way, not that it is one kind of dry philosophy, Maharaj speaking, you know, we must give everything unto lotus feet of Gurudev in the time of Diksha. Kapat. We should not think that way. We must be ready. We must always be ready, like fire brigade man, to give everything unto, even life. Why not so? Just I told the example of, you know, Goswami Maharaj. Penniless Goswami Maharaj came and give everything. Prabhupada, you know, like, you know, danda, pay prostrate danda unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, speaking, Prabhupada, now today I am only yours. I am only yours. Now you like to throw me out or give me a space, you know, place unto a lotus feet, that's up to you. Goswami Maharaj giving this. What to speak about Goswami Maharaj of Guru Varga? The disciple of Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, Krishna Mahi Devi Didi. She gave everything, nothing left. All given to, you know, given to Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Now it is one kind of dream, it is one kind of lecture only. You know, we are going to, Maharaj, if I am not going to give everything unto the lotus feet of Gurupad Padma, it is not at all possible for me to realize tattva. Be careful. Then I can become a cheater. Always be ready to offer everything, your life, soul, all your belongings I am not, you know, a cheater guru can snatch everything from you, but I am speaking about Sadguru, what Prabhupada wanted to speak, Acharya Seed. A pure Acharya is so excellent, so essence, so powerful, he is just equal to Supreme Lord, Balaramji Maharaj. Shakshad Harityana Samasya Sasti, Ruktas Tata Bhavati Visadvi, Kintu Pabarja Piyavatasya, Bande Guresh Charana. So we must be very ready to give all our life and, oh Maharaj, if I give away what I can eat, nothing can left Maharaj, especially it is Corona period. Oh, I am giving something to Maharaj, okay. Okay. No, a Sadguru never expect any donation, nothing from you. He like to give you. You know, like to give you. How? It is in Shastra, it is written. It is Shastra, it is written. Guru Vaishnava. If Guru Vaishnava going to speak me one syllable, one, you know, one word, maybe. You know, and then if I am going to change my life, then by selling the whole world, I cannot pay to him. Any kind of, you know, thing Guru Vaishnava giving to us, Tathagyan or love or anything Guru Vaishnava giving, a spontaneous, you know, affection to you all, you can never pay him. Don't try to think, if I can, you know, this come amount, if I give donation, maybe I am going to pay. No! Not at all. It is not payable. How we can pay? We are indebted to Gurupad Padma, Prabhupada Bhakti. Never in my life. This is the teaching of Krishna. Krishna already spoke this way, Mahaprabhu many times. Who is going to hear? Eh? Who is going to hear? Eh? Nobody likes to hear. And everything, you know, everything, you know, should be given unto lotus feet of Gurupada. Many times, you know, Na pare aham niravadda sangyujam jama avajano durjano griho singkala sangrishya tadva pratiyatu sadhuna. Who told? Krishna told to Gopikas. Because Gopikas, they are guru. Radharani, topmost guru. And after the review, all Sakhi Manjari Tattva, all guru. All guru. We are always, you know, going to lick. We are going to lick their lotus feet. You know, we want to lick the lotus feet of Gurupad Padma like dog. It's my identity, especially my identity. I'm the dog of Guru Bhargava. I like to lick their lotus feet, enjoy, you know, seva mood. I like to get. This is my only craving desire. I like to pray unto lotus feet of Supreme Lord. So this way I can give one by example, one by one. Don't think that is a dry philosophy, Maharaj speaking, you know, without giving, offering everything top to bottom unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma, nobody can get Dibbo. I don't need Dibbo Gan Maharaj. I am going to lose my position and money, everything. Who is going to act like a foolish? No, I cannot give. Then you cannot get Dibbo Gan. That's why Bodhi Maharaj is our Acharya, going to show us that this should be the mood. I must give everything. I must give everything to Guru Padma Vaishnava. You know, there's a mood, you know. This way, we are kapat. That's why we are not getting result. Kapat can never get result. Kapat can never get result. Prabhupada speaking, especially Prabhupada speaking, who is going to arrange my complete benefit, spiritual benefit? Who is going to arrange my complete spiritual benefit? I am going to submit unto his lotus feet. I am not going to submit unto the lotus feet of a cheater guru. Prabhupada speaking, he who can arrange all my 100% perfect in a mangal, total mangal, completely, I like to submit unto his lotus feet. I'm not going to show my submission unto the lotus feet of a cheetah guru. You know, if all the way we are always thinking, I am the doer, it is all my building, all my property, I can play politics with Guru Vaishnava. Okay, it is your privilege, you can play politics with, and ultimately you can see who is going to check up after death, you know. They are actually Mayavadi. Their mood is like that. Who is going to check after that what is having? That's why he is Mayavadi. Mayavadi, you see. They are going to expect something in return. They are going to expect something in return. I can speak one incident. Maybe today I can touch this point. You heard the name of Kalapahar, you know. Heard the name of Kalapahar, you know. Heard the name of Kalapahar. He is, you know, family all, you know, father, mother, everybody, devotee. He was also devotee. You know, everybody, when the Brahmanas used to worship Vishnu, Archana, everything. One day, due to some problem, what happened? He went to Puri and without water and without any prasadam, without water, he was fasting for 7-10 days and praying unto lotus feet of Jagannath. The Jagannath, this is a situation, you must change the situation, otherwise. But Jagannath not going to give any response. After 10 days, when he finds Jagannath not going to pay any attention to his prayer, then he wanted to express his demonic character. He come with this conclusion, Jagannath, nothing Jagannath is useless, he wooden structure, nothing else, I can destroy everything. Then after that he become demonic character, he started destroying all temples and everything. He took the shelter of, you know, Muslim king, from Delhi, Bengal, with their help, they started destroying all different kind of temples and everything. Nothing, they're all false. They started destroying. This is our bhakti. We are also one, you know, Kalapahar. We are also, we want to get some benefit from Guru. If Guru Pad, Guru Pad, then who is going to serve? Huh? Useless. I must think about my profit and loss account. This is my mood. So, what kind of spiritual improvement I can expect in my life? What kind of? If Guru Bhargo Bhagavan not going to speak anything, give anything, then I am going to throw salgram, nishingadva, useless, all stone and, you know, wooden structure, useless, nothing. You know, in Bengali Harikatha, in Bindapur I was speaking, that we are material people, sometimes you can take information. You can take information that material people sometimes arrange in Satyanarayan Puja. Satyanarayan Puja. You know, they are arranging. So I was bound to speak in a very joking mood. Well, they are doing Satyanarayan Puja sometime to fulfill their desire. Satyanarayan, I am going to do puja. If you can fulfill my desire, then I can worship again next year. Maharaj, today they are going to worship. Today they are going to worship Satyanarayan. If Satyanarayan not going to fulfill their heart, then they can come with the comment that Mithanarayan. Mithanarayan. This is not Satyanarayan. He is Mithanarayan. All lie, bogus, all fool, all useless. This is our devotion. We come in front of your Guru Vaishnava, everything, hearing Harikatha. But we cannot change your heart because there is so much aparat. I can put challenge, if there is no aparat, nothing, nam aparat, dam aparat, you know, so much aparat, you know. In family life also, family, I can discuss this point in details, you know. I can make a accurate operation, you know, operation on this subject. In family life also, when husband going to ignore wife, wife going to ignore children, but they don't know. They are already doing Harinam, everything. I can discuss what Bhaktivinoda Thakur told in Bhajan Rahasya, all in details. Aparadha, what different kind of aparadhas, how to get respite. So even one husband going to ignore wife. Wife is very good, chaste, not doing anything, but he is going to throw wife, and wife is not, cannot, wife unable to maintain his her life somehow, and like selfish, husband going to lead his life because he has money. This is also great aparat. We cannot ignore. There should be mutual understandings of so that we can protect our seva and bhajan mood. Not that we enjoying mood. If enjoying mood is there, then then each and every step of our life we can meet with trouble. If there is enjoying mood inside my heart, then each and every minute, fraction of second, I am going to meet with trouble. Bhajan is not at all possible. Anno nore, even those who are different kind of jiva in this world, if I am unnecessarily going to give trouble to them, is also a big problem. With respect to Krishna seva, for the reason of Krishna seva, I am going to give some, going to take some step, then no problem, because it is a standing instruction of Bhagavan, that man nimitta kritam papam dharmaya kalpati. Follow what I say. As Siddhar Goswami had told, when some dacoits came to abduct Vigraha from temple, then that society from this way, they started firing, and everybody coming to Siddhar Goswami complaining, they are devotee, they are shooting, they are firing. Yeah, what is devotee? They should not do this kind of Siddhar Maharaj thing. Yeah. If Ishtadev deity, somebody going to take away, then it is called Tinadapi, to throw fire. You can remember the Acharya, first Acharya of Ranganatham, Alwar, Tiruppan Alwar. By the desire of Krishna, he found that Vigraha inside deep forest. In deep forest he discovered, who is Vishnu? So nice, And in the night time, came in dream and speaking, you must arrange one big temple for me. Prabhu, who can give me money? How I can do? Somehow you have to arrange big temple. Somehow. So when Guru Vaishnava going to test you, sometimes speaking, I don't know how you can do. I don't know, that is your headache. But it is my instruction, you have to do it. Upamannu was giving instruction, Gurudev, so merciless. Hey Upamannu, what you are drinking? Your health is very good. Gurudev, actually in forest I am taking some milk from Gomata, you give me this. No, you have no right to drink milk from Gomata, because milk actually those calf they can take. Don't take. Okay Gurudev, okay. After that, Upamannu cannot get anything in the forest. Somehow, when those calf taking enough milk, they are vomiting, and Upamannu going to drink. And after that, Gurudev, after some time, Gurudev meeting him, he meet Gurudev, hey, your health is very good, what you are taking? Gurudev, actually cough, they are taking enough milk, after that they are vomiting. No, for you they are merciful, for you they are vomiting, don't do that. And first, when started, then in the beginning, Upamannu was begging some rice, everything. Then Gurudev, how you are maintaining your life? Gurudev, I am begging, right? No, you have no right. You have no right. All begging, what you are begging, you have to give to Gurudev. It is in Shastra. Oh, really? Okay. Then from next time, Upamannu started begging two times. First time is coming into lotus feet of Gurudev, this begging. After second time going and again begging, and getting everything. Then when he meet Gurudev say, hey, how you are maintaining your body? Your health is very good, I see. Gurudev, first time I beg and give to you, and second time I'm going to beg for... No! Sarvam Gurave Datya. Sarvam Guru... You don't know foolish number one? You are doing Guru Seva? Foolish! You have to give everything. Okay, Gurudev, I can give everything. Then Upamannu, ultimately, if I have nothing to eat, so hungry at a small boy, ultimately, he was bound to take some poison leaf, and become blind. It was idealism of Guru Seva. Kures, forever, infinity period, we are going to sing the glories of Kuresh. Kures, the servant of Guru Pad Padmala, Ramanujacharya. Nobody can forget. Nobody can forget, nobody can forget this kind of seva. Aha. Kuresh, for infinity pure, we are expecting lotus feet from your lotus feet. You know, dust particle from your lotus feet. So this way, we should not cheat Guru Padma, Guru Vaishnava. We have no right to cheat Guru Vaishnava, because they can cheat us. Who can cheat Guru Vaishnava? Nobody can cheat Guru Vaishnava. They are very clever. They can understand your mood, everything. So, now you come to this point. Sarvam Gurave Dadyat. Sarvam Gurave Dadyat. You know? Sarvam Gurave. You have to give everything unto the lotus feet of Guru Padma. So, how you can maintain your life? Actually, you should not think about how to maintain your life if you are 100% dedicated soul. Because submission me, I can discuss so many things, I can discuss tomorrow, not today. So, you can remember one sloka from Vaishnava Tantra Bhakka. It is very famous in our, you know, Vaishnava, you know, Darshan. Anukullasya sankalpa pratikulla vibarjanam rakshasya shiti vishyasya guptitya varanam tatha atto nikhepa karpannam saravidha saranagati. You can say, Maharaj, I am totally inclined unto your lotus feet. Hey, Maharaj, I am bandit soul. You need not so in. No. So, this way, if I like to prove that I am 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Path Padma, and if I am not going to fulfill all this condition, anukullasya sankalpa pratikulla vibarjanam rakshasya sheti vishyasya guptitya varanam tatha atmo nikhepa karpanyam saravidha saranagati shikhai saranagati bhakti ropran. Every day we are singing in the morning time. Every day you have to do Sankirtan. Every day you will have to do Sankirtan. Don't stop Sankirtan. You know. Don't try to think your, you know, about your own health, everything, and don't stop Sankirtan. Not that. Every day you will have to do Sankirtan. Anywhere you are staying, you have to do Sankirtan. Don't stop Sankirtan. Yeah. So, Anukulla Sada, I can see. Vaina, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Babu Jive Daya Kari. Saparsata Siyadhamo Saha Avatari Ottanta Durlava Premo Karibare Dan Shikhaya Saranagati Bhakti Rapran Shikhaya Saranagati Bhakti Rapran. So, Dainyatma Nivedana Gopti Tevarana Avasara Khiven Kishno Vishasho palano, hena bhakti anukulo matro karjero sikaro bhakti pati kulo bhavo barjanangi karo sharango saranagati hoi bejaharo taharo parthana sune shinando kumaro jiboru rupo sanatane tano pade dante tino ori bhakati vinodo pare duhu pado dori kandiya bale ami to yadhamo shikhayo saranagoti bhakati raprano. So you should remember, it is not dry philosophy. Why the desire of Guru Vaishnava, you know, automatically, you know, Krishna going to take up. You think you are going to give donation, but by the inspiration Mithyananda you are doing. Don't think that way, you know, a doership actually, you know. So, it is the arrangement of Prabhu. If Prabhu giving inspiration to somebody, you know, we know, in one temple, you know, there was a very hard period, that time was very critical period, how to maintain life. There was no rice, nothing, everything, all finished. that they are the disciples are speaking to Guru Pad Padma, he is actually Sadguru also. I know. Saying, Gurudev, there is no rice, what to cook? Gurudev, you see, you close the temple gate and start singing kirtan. Everything, Mahamantra, go on singing kirtan. Madam, how to cook? Hey, you sit. I say you sit and go on doing kirtan from my heart. Go on. Don't ask anything to Krishna. They started doing kirtan. Around 11 o'clock, somebody knock. Hey, open the door, open the door. Who coming? Who coming? Actually, come, I come with all, you know, sack of rice and dal, chapati, dal and oil. Oh my God. You know, in the life of Jajabhagwa Singh Maharaj, they also, you know. It is actually 100% proved in the life of Bhaktivedanta Madhava Singh Maharaj. There was a famine that time. We heart we out. Narottama Brahmachari, our Bharati Maharaj, Krishna Vallabh Brahmachari, Tito Maharaj, all there. You know, and it was Janmashtami day, Bhaktivedanta Madhava Singh speaking Harikatha. After that, everybody saying, Gurudev, and we have nothing in the Bandara. So you don't announce that tomorrow, you don't invite everybody, Gurudev. If you invite, then they can throw bricks on our temple. But Gurudev laughing. But there is no sufficient rice, shall not, we cannot do Nandotsav. What to do? After Harikatha is over, Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj is very enjoying mood speaking. Tomorrow is Nanda Utsav. You can all come to take prasadam in our temple. Oh my God! Everybody crying. What Gurudev doing? Ha! Everybody can beat us. Huh? We invite and cannot give anything. Oh my God! Gurudev, Gurudev laughing and gone to his bhajan kutir. After which everything gone to his bhajan. Night time almost 2 o'clock, and one Punjab lorry. Big lorry coming and knocking the door. Hey, open the door. And who knocking night 2 o'clock? Are we are sent by some set big from Punjab, you know, with what? Well, then we bring all dal, chapati and dal, you know, rice, wheat, you know, everything while all full lorry, Punjab lorry. Even for 1 year, if you go on spending, you cannot spend. What kind of bandara you can speak? Eh? So people, they have no saranagati, no belief in Guru Vaishnava. That's why they are busy with argument. They are always busy with argument. Logical into Mara, this is very good, nice design. If I do this, this, that, I speak you, do this way. You will have to do this way. You have to do this way. Why you are going to change? Foolish number one. We are going to protect the interest of Krishna. You are going to think about this, that, this. No! Even I am not going to protect my self-interest. No! That way, you can think about how best possible way we can do Sankirtan, all this, that. You know. So, 100% Saranagati, if there, then surely your application can reach the lotus feet of Krishna. If 100% Saranagati is there, if 100% Saranagati is there, then be sure your application going to touch the lotus feet of Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Guru Varga. But we cannot send our application directly because we have bonded soul. Somehow we have no link with that Vaikuntha Jagat. That's why it is written in Kirtan. Vaishnaviro Abedane. Krishna dayamayo eheno pamuro poti haiven sadayo. I can pray unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Guru Vaishnava can have direct relation with Krishna. They can. So now you understand the gravity of acharyaship. You are playing so long, you are playing whole world blind. They don't know. Never they like to discuss this point. Never they learn in whole, you know, except Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda or Guru, you know, some upper Guru, not everybody. All they like to hide, they like to hide the secret Guru Vaishnava Tattva, so that they can make fool of them. But it is one kind of jivhingsa. It is one kind of jivhingsa. I cannot, you know, play with you all that way. You know, even if you all are going to leave me alone, still I cannot cheat you. Not possible. Still I can speak heavy way. Heavy way I can beat you. I can speak all rubbish. You know, like Sukhdev Goswami again. Shaushtabaraha kharo sangstuta purushaha. You know. Shaw mean? Eh? Kukur, dog. Sukhdev Goswami, they are dog. They are pig. They are ass. You know, Bhakti Mutukar also speaking. You know, Bhakti Mutukar also speaking, no? That like ass, like Godhoberopai, like ass, we are going to bear on the burden. If we are going to get the burden, then it is okay. If there is no burden of family, we are so foolish, we want to increase the burden of, you know, burden. A prakita jagat is totally different, you know. That is written, jaro vidya yato mayar vaibhav. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, jaro vidya yato mayar vaibhav tomar bhajane badha anitya samsare moho janmiya jibke karaye gadha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, I am not speaking. Jaro vidya, you are having Eparsius, London, these, there are so many degrees, you know. What use if we cannot apply in Krishna bhajan? Jaro vidya jato mayar vaibhav, it is the appliances of maya. It is one kind of impediments in the way of your actual bhajan. So we don't like to get any designation, any title, nothing. People can ignore me. Those who are blind, they can ignore me. Those who are genuine, they can understand my heart. That's why you told, huh? It is my success. It is my success that there is a demonic character not coming in front of me. This is my success. I cannot allow them to come in front of me. Even somebody coming in guise of, you know, in guise of something devotee, still I can detect and throw them out. I have no connection. I don't like to keep any connection with. It is the first resolution. It is the first resolution in your life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. I can discuss tomorrow, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. It is life and breath. It is respiration. It is just respiration, the vital thing of our bhajan. If we are going to do a satsanga, we can never come out successful. Somehow we have to increase our sincerity, automatically divine help. By divine we can understand this is wrong, this is right, this is wrong, this is right. Even some Grihastha Bhakta from foreign, they also at present understand. Previously they couldn't understand. Their Gurudev gone, anyway they enjoying some kipa of Guru Padma. So somehow now they understand this is kapat, this is right. Even, you know, they can understand who is cheater, who is, you know. Even there is Siddhanta Virod, they can understand wrong Siddhanta is speaking. So long, for so long they are hearing Siddhanta, Siddhanta, Vichar. Now they can understand because they are less interested to do asasanga. If you are going to maintain both satsanga, asasanga, you want to keep balance, then I can give one example. You are standing on, depending on two boats floating in water, you know. Two boats are there, two boats floating in water. You are keeping one leg in one boat, another leg in another. Prabhupada used to give this example. If you are so foolish, you are going to stand, one leg is one boat and another leg is another boat. What will happen? Two boats can slide away from each other. You can go down into water. This is the situation happening in your life. I don't know what kind of harikatha you have heard in your life. I don't know. I cannot understand. Which cannot give you any improvement in your life previously. I don't know. What kind of Gurudev you have accepted. You know, why? It is the rule there. Prabhupada speaking in harikatha. You know. Abhaishnava, Abhaishnava, Mukhopadishtam, Mantrena, Nirayam, Bhajet. I can discuss this point tomorrow. अवैष्णव मुखोपदिष्टम मंत्रेण निरयम वर्जित पुनश्च विधिना ग्राहेत वैष्णववाद गुरु एट ऑल इफ यू हैव डन एट ऑल यू हैव डन मिस्टेक इन योर लाइफ यू हैव एक्सेप्टेड मायावादी एज गुरु अ फॉल्स गुरु चीटर गुरु एवरीथिंग नाउ इट इज अ रूल दैट यू कैन थ्रो दैट गुरु एंड एक्सेप्ट वन वैष्णव गुरु इज परफेक्ट अदरवाइज इन योर होल लाइफ यू कैन नॉट गेट एनी सोल्यूशन ऑफ योर भजन एंड अनुकूल्यस्य संकल्प प्रतिकूल्य विवर्जनम रक्षेष्यति विश्वास गुप्तित्व वर्णम यथा आत्मनिक्षेप कार्पण्यम सर्वविदा शरणागति दिस यू नो आई कैन डिस्कस ऑल इन डिटेल्स टुमोरो नॉट टुडे टाइम कैन नॉट परमिट टुडे आई लाइक टू टच द श्लोक आई स्टार्टेड विथ मर्तो जदा त्यक्तो समस्त कर्मा निवेदितात्मा विचिकीर्षितो मे तदा अमृतत्वं प्रतिपद्यमानो मयात्म भूयायो च कल्पते वै मर्तो जदा त्यक्तो समस्त कर्मा निवेदितात्मा विचिकीर्षितो मे तदा अमृतत्वं प्रतिपद्यमानो मयात्म भूयायो च कल्पते वै मैन इज मोर्टल To R is human. To R is human. Man is mortal. We learn from childhood. But we don't understand the meaning. To R is human. Yes. To R is human. And man is mortal. Mean? Oh, Maharaj, today we'll have to understand. So long you are hearing this word, they cannot understand. Man is mortal, money, anyhow. Your bank account, your huge property, your manpower, money power, somehow, if you can apply somehow, you are not going to live forever. What is the mathematical interpretation of your life? What is the mathematical interpretation of your life? If you understand, immediately you can run for a genuine acharya. You don't understand, you are in maya. That's why you are not feeling any urgency. You are feeling any importance. Follow what I say. What is the mathematical interpretation of our life? Suppose I am going to leave my body 62 years something. Then I will have to calculate when I took birth. From there, I will have to calculate gradually. So I took birth there. So this man, so 62 years, maybe 61 years or 62 years, and 2 months, 2 months, I know, 2 months, you know, 5 weeks, two months, 2 weeks, you know, 5 days, you know, 5 hours, you know, 10 seconds. After that, fraction of second. From your taking birth, you can calculate, and when you are going to leave your body, so long you was. So long you are there in this material world, manifesting your lila. Human body is so unstable. So you see, this is the mathematical interpretation of your life. You have no respite. You can, no way, no alternative. No alternative except Hari Bhajan. There is no alternative except Hari Bhajan. No alternative. Today or tomorrow, if you would like to kick me, okay. But tomorrow, day after tomorrow, next life or next life, anyhow, there is no alternative. Maybe you are angry with me because I am speaking about, you know, so rough, you know. But I am bound to speak that way. What to speak? I cannot hide. So, today or tomorrow you will have to do Krishna bhajan because there is no alternative. The procedure spoken here in Bhagavata Mahapuran, 11th canto, when mortal, man is mortal, when a man anyhow, when like to throw everything, all his duty, everything, he can remember, you see, sarva dharmana parityajya mam ekam saranam bhajo aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami ma sucho. But Arjuna still putting argument. Whereas actually Krishna speaking, sarva dharma, any kind of, you know, Veda, you know, Laukik dharma, general phenomena or any kind of dharma, body dharma, social dharma, you know, general, you know, conception of your dharma, so-called dharma, all you have to show. Sarva dharma na parityajya mam ekam sarnam. Only and only we will have to take shelter unto my lotus feet. I promise you, aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshai shami masu. Don't try to repent. Be sure that I am going to deliver you. I am starting from Gita, you know, so that you can understand. There can be some common sense. You can develop some common sense, you know. Arjun's in front of Arjun, Krishna speaking that way. Arjun speak in front of Arjun, Krishna speaking that way. Even after that also, Arjun putting some question. Okay, after that speaking, na kvarishye bachanam tava. Okay, now I understand, I like to follow your word. But Arjun speaking this way. But still, Arjun could not realize the vital point of Gita. How I know? Mane Arjun himself speaking. Arjun is not ordinary man. Eternal person. But still, this kind of leela. When Krishna gone from this material world, eternal abode already gone, all, you know, Jadav, Jodubangs, everything gone. When Arjun coming back from Dwarka, in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, with craving mood, crying and speaking, oh heavily, oh Rajan, I am now, deprived. How? Harina Bandhurupina, my friend Krishna now deprived me. He gone. Yes, he gone. Everything gone. Same Arjun there. Same Gandip. Same thing. Same chariot, everything. But that power gone. Rajan, that power gone. I am repenting. I am losing everything except Krishna. Oh, really? Krishna gone. Banchitoham Rajan, Harina Bandhu Rupina. I am deprived by Krishna. Krishna gone, leaving everything. That same Arjun there, same Gandip, bow and arrow, everything, same chariot. But where that power gone, everything? Where that power? Guru Kipa Hi Kevalam. We cannot think that way. It is my power. I am maintaining more. I am speaking Harikatha. Then I am idiot number one beast. I should not speak that way. All coming by the power of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, all Guru Varga, they are, you know, sitting inside my heart and giving me inspiration to speak that way. That much I can speak. I have no audacity to speak that I am a big speaker. I am not opening one competition with anybody. I can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada and speak. I am not opening one competition of Harikatha. Because Harikatha is not a matter of competition. Somebody can open one exhibition of competition, that I can allow him to do that. But I cannot fight with them. Nobody. So this way, you see, Arjun gone. Arjun now crying in front of, because Krishna gone. So this way, when Arjun could realize the total, you know things of Gita, when Arjun could digest, when Arjun could digest and assimilate Gita, you know, I am not making any dry philosophy. I am speaking about the absolute truth is written in Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran. Arjun speaking himself, I can open and show you. You are blind, you cannot see. You are blind, you cannot see. I can show you. Arjun speaking. So long I was thinking him as my friend, you know, playing with him, speaking all, you know, joking with him. Sayana bhojana, during taking prasadam, and on, you know, in sleeping, and on joking all the time. Now I realize who is my friend, Krishna. Now today when Krishna gone, now today when Krishna gone, now I can realize the essence of Bhagavad Gita. In front of all enemies, you know, Kaurava, my chariot was there. Krishna wanted to speak me something. And then that time I couldn't realize fully. Sangrama Murdhani. Sangrama Murdhani, mane in the junction point, when big fighting going to start, Kuru and Pandav, in that junction, at that point, Sangrama Murdhani, what he told, advice was given by Krishna as Gita. Now, come on, now after Krishna gone, now I realize, oh my God, now I realize the essence of Gita, whole teachings of Krishna. Now I can, you know, remember everything. Sometimes we are so idiot, so foolish, when Guru Vaishnav shouting in front of us, speaking all about Sikha, we are less interested to accept. When Guru Vaishnav gone, then in front of his samadhi, we start crying. Gurudev, you wanted to rectify me all the time, wanted to speak that way, but I was not ready to accept it. Now you've gone, how I can get respite, you know, how, who can? Then Gurudev can come in different form, Sadguru can come, same Guru can come, because Guru Tattva is Akhanda Tattva, to guide me, if I'm sincere, honest, you know, don't try to make my statement false. Yesterday I told, all my honest children mean I am speaking with affection, don't try to make my, you know, this remark false, try to prove that it is true, that Maharaj told, we are all honest, we try to at least follow honest path, we like to understand bhakti, you know, pure devotional track. I can try to discuss all in details tomorrow. Today time cannot permit, so please excuse me. I have to run to for some other seva. I like to stop it. Kipaya hori kirtana muti dharam dharani varaharaka gaurajanam janakadika vasala snigdha padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada prabhupada padam pranamami sada प्रभुपाद पदम वांच कल्पतरुवस्य के पास सिंधु व्यवचा पतितानं पावन भो वैष्णवभ्यो नमो नमः.